Now we come to the nucleus. Okay. Now nucleus was first described by Robert Brown. Okay. So the description of the nucleus was given by Robert Brown in 1831. The material of the nucleus stained by the basic dyes was given the name chromatin by Fleming. Normally, a cell has only one nucleus. Some cells have more than one. Some mature cells lack nucleus, example mammalian RBC and sieve tube cells of the vascular plants. Okay, so nucleus was first observed by Robert Brown in 1831. The material of the nucleus, when stained by a basic dye, it was given the name chromatin because it was stained. Chroma means color, and thin threads, colored threads, which were observed were called chromatin by Fleming. Normally, a cell has only one nucleus, but some cells can have more than one. Some mature cells lack nucleus, example mammalian RBC and sieve tube cells of the vascular plants. So see here, you can see in the diagram, these are the thread-like structures which are the chromatin inside the nucleus, and this is the nuclear lamina. This is the nuclear membrane. As we know that we are eukaryotic organisms, so nuclear membrane is present in a eukaryotic organisms. Okay. Now the interface nucleus will have nuclear envelope, nuclear matrix, chromatin and nucleolus. Okay. So the nuclear envelope is the nuclear membrane. This is the nuclear envelope. These are the chromatin, the thread-like structure you can see. This central part is the nucleolus. Okay. And this hole is the nuclear matrix. Now when we are talking about nuclear envelope, it is double layered membrane with a space between 10 to 15 nanometer called the perinuclear space. It is a barrier between the materials in the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Outer membrane usually is continuous with the ER and also bears ribosomes on it, because we know that there is a protein synthesis which is taken by the function of the protein synthesis done by ER. So the message as to which protein is synthesized will come from the nucleus. So there is a need for the nucleus and ER to be very close to each other. Okay, so a lot of energy is not wasted for the transport of the material to the ER. So they are associated in a cell very near to each other. Now this nuclear envelope has minute pores formed by the fusion of its two membranes. These are the passages for the movement of RNA protein between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Okay. So nuclear envelope is a double layered membrane with a space between 10 to 15 nanometer called the perinuclear space. It is a barrier between the materials in the nucleus and cytoplasm. Outer membrane usually is continuous with the ER and also bears ribosomes on it. Okay. Nuclear envelope has minute pores. Okay, these, see, you can see orange color channel like. These are nothing but the pores which are acting as a channel. So this will help in the movement of the material which is inside the nuclear matrix into the cytoplasmic matrix. These are the passages for the movement of RNA and protein between nucleus and cytoplasm. Okay, now what is chromatin? Chromatin is nothing but a network of nucleoprotein fibers. Okay, see here in the diagram you can see the fibers, you can see our chromatin. These are made up of nothing but DNA plus basic proteins that are histone plus non-histone proteins and RNA. So all the things like DNA, basic proteins, that is a histone, non-histone proteins and RNA are associated inside the this chromatin. Okay, and during cell division, this chromatin condenses to form the chromosome. Okay, during cell division, this chromatin will be condensed to form the chromosome. Okay, so chromatin is what? Chromatin is a network of nucleoprotein fibers which is made up of DNA, okay, histone and non-histone and RNA. Okay, so inside it we saw that there is a presence of a nucleolus. So nucleolus is what? It is one or no more non-membranous spherical bodies. It is continuous with the nucleoplasm and it is site for ribosomal RNA synthesis. So there can be question in the examination as to what is the site for ribosomal RNA synthesis. So you need to know that it is what? It is the nucleolus, which is the site for ribosomal RNA synthesis. Okay. So what all structures we saw in the nucleus? We saw the nuclear envelope, nuclear matrix, chromatin and nucleolus. In nuclear envelope, we saw that is a double layered membrane. Okay, it acts as a barrier between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. The outer membrane is usually continuous with the ER and also bears what? Ribosomes on it. Nuclear envelope has minute pores formed by the fusion of two membranes. These are the passages for the movement. They are the passages for the movement of RNA and protein between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Then we saw the chromatin. They are the network of nucleoprotein fibers, which are made up of DNA, histone, non-histone, and RNA. And during cell division, these are converted into chromosome. Then came the nucleolus, which is one or more non-membranous spherical structures, which are continuous with the cell nucleoplasm and their site for ribosomal RNA synthesis. Now comes the chromosome. A human cell has about 2 meter long DNA distributed among its 46 chromosomes, that is 23 pairs. Okay, this pair of chromosomes are only visible during the cell division. Otherwise, they are present like thin threads, which is chromatin. So a human cell has about 2 meter long DNA distributed among its 46, 23 pairs of chromosomes. Every chromosome has a primary constriction. See here, you can see in the diagram, there is a primary constriction. Okay, here, see this curve is nothing but the primary constriction. Okay, that is the centrosome. So this central structure is what is the centrosome. Okay, and on the sides of which disc-shaped structures are present and they are called kinetochores. See here, you can see this disc-shaped structure is present. Here you can see this shapes. So these are not nothing but kinetochores. Okay, so chromosome is a X-shaped structure. Okay, and there is a constriction in this, like this is an X-shaped structure. So this constriction is nothing but the centrosome, and disc-like structures will be present here, like here. Okay, and these are nothing but the kinetochore. And during cell division, the mitotic spindle fibers we saw earlier will be attached to this centromere through the kinetochore. See, actual diagram of a chromosome is given here. It is like this. The green disc you can see here in the diagram are nothing but kinetochores. Now, based on the position of the centromere, chromosomes can be divided into four types. Okay. First is metacentric. This is the middle, the centromere present here is in the middle and it is dividing the chromosome into two equal parts. Okay, so the first one here you can see in the diagram is what? It is metacentric. Then it is subcentric. The middle centrosome is nearer to one end. Okay, see here in this chromosome you can see the difference, as one arm is, these arms are little longer and these are little smaller. So centrosome is nearer to one end, forming one shorter arm and one longer arm. Acrocentric, that is, it is very close to the other end. See here, this is a short arm and this is a long arm. And one very long arm, okay. And the telocentric, that is the terminal centromere, okay. So some chromosomes have non-staining secondary constriction at a constant location and it is called a satellite. So here you can see that on the top there is a secondary constriction. First constriction is this. Okay, this is the curve and the second constriction is here and they are nothing but the satellites. Okay, so according to the position of centromere, chromosomes are divided into four types: metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, and telocentric. Then comes the microbodies. Microbodies are nothing but these are the membrane bound minute vesicles that contain various enzymes, and they are present in both plant and animals. Okay. So microbodies are nothing but they are the membrane bound minute vesicles that contain various enzymes present in both plant and animal cells. This is the lipid bilayer and this is the plasma membrane. Okay. Now we'll see the difference between the plant and animal cell. So in plant cell, cell wall is present. In animal cell, it is absent. Okay. We know that chloroplast is present, so plasters are present in plant cell, and these are the you can give many differences between the plants and animals, but these are some of the basic differences. Plastids are present, and in animal cell plastids are absent. A large central vacuole is present inside the plant cell, but many small vacuoles are present inside the animal cell, and centrioles are absent and here centrioles are present. Okay. Then comes the prokaryotic and the eukaryotic cell difference. So prokaryotics are smaller, eukaryotic cells are larger. Genetic material is in the form of nucleoid here, and here it forms a nucleus. Nuclear membrane is absent, here it is present. Membrane bound organelles are present and eukaryotic are absent, and here they are present. Here you will find circular DNA and here we find linear DNA. And ribosomes are of 70S type, and here the ribosomes are of 80S type. Okay, so here we saw what? We saw four types of chromosome, that is metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric and telocentric. And these kind of chromosome structure is typically visualized during the cell division phases. Okay. The difference between the plant and the animal cell are: cell wall is present in the plant cell, animal cell it's absent. Plastids are present, plastids are absent. Large central vacuole, many small vacuoles, and centrioles are absent, and here they are present. Okay, when we are talking about this prokaryotic cell, generally they are smaller, eukaryotic cell are larger. Genetic material is in the form of nucleoid, here it is forming a nucleus structure. Nuclear membrane is present, here it is absent, and here in the eukaryotic cell it is present. Membrane bound organelles are absent here, and membrane bound organelles are present in the eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells generally have circular DNA, and here we find linear DNA. And ribosomes in the prokaryotic cell are of 70S type, and in eukaryotes it's 80S type, but prokaryotic cells do have 70S ribosomes in the plastids and the mitochondria. Okay, you have to remember this. Generally the cell will have 80S type of ribosome inside the nucleus, but inside the plastid, that is the chloroplast and the mitochondria, these cells will have what? Prokaryotic ribosome, that is 70S, and S here is nothing but the sedimentation coefficient. Okay, so here we saw differences between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. We saw differences between the plant and animal cell. Then we saw microbodies, which are nothing but the membrane bound minute vesicles that contain various enzymes, and they are present in both plant and animal cell. We saw types of chromosome. We saw the basic components of the nucleus, like nucleolus, chromatin, nuclear envelope, okay, and nuclear matrix, which is nucleoplasm. And we also know that nucleoplasm and cytoplasm gives us what? Gives us the protoplasm. So when anybody is saying that what is the protoplasm, this thing is present inside the protoplasm, so that particular person is talking about both the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm. Okay, then we saw the nucleus structure, which was first described by Robert Brown, and it was stain and chromatin was observed by Fleming. Okay, and generally cells have only one nucleus, but some cells may lack nucleus, or may be present more than one, like in mammalian RBC we don't have nucleus, as to hemoglobin is present, and due to which if nucleus would have been present, then hemoglobin would not have got so much space to be there. And we know that hemoglobin is necessary for our for transport of oxygen. So to minimize the space, the the nucleus in the RBC is not there, so that hemoglobin can be present in maximum space. Okay, so this was all about nucleus and the general differences between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Here, this last point you have to remember that the ATS ribosomes are present in eukaryotic cell, but plastids and mitochondria, plastids when you are talking about plants and mitochondria in both will have what, 70S, because they will be capable, they are having their own genetic material and to some extent they are capable of making their own proteins. Okay.